Next is a lengthier problem, but don't worry, it just needs these formulas that you study, that is the unit tangent vector, kappa, and the unit normal vector, and basic differentiation. So let us see the problem. Show that if f is a twice differentiable function of x, then the curvature of the graph of y is equal to f of x is kappa of x is equal to magnitude of f double dash of x by 1 plus f dash of x whole square whole raised to 3 by 2. Use the formula to find the curvature of y is equal to natural log of cos x, where x is from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, so 3 by 2. Here it has been given that f is a twice differentiable function of x and kappa is also in terms of x. You know two formulas of kappa, one is magnitude of dt by ds and the other one is 1 by magnitude of v of t into magnitude of dt by t dt, where t was the parameter of the given curve. Here kappa of x is given in the parameter of the given curve, it's a given parameter, so you have to use this formula. Now let us see how to solve this. Solution: the curve given to you was y is equal to f of x, but you need r of x of r of t in terms of I, j and k. So how are you going to parametrize the curve? You can see that for each x you have a y which is equal to f of x. So suppose that you take x as x itself, then you have y is equal to f of x, so that r of x can be set as x I cap plus f of x j cap. You know that we are going to find kappa with the formula 1 by magnitude of v into magnitude of dt by dt. For this, what do you need first? You need the magnitude of v, for that velocity should be found out. So what is v of x? V of x is the derivative of r of x and it will be equal to I cap plus f dash of x j cap. Thus magnitude of v of x will be root of 1 plus f dash of x the whole square. So from here you have to find t first, and t was equal to v by magnitude of v. So it is equal to I cap plus f dash of x j cap by root of 1 plus f dash of x the whole square. This can be split into I cap and j cap as 1 by root of 1 plus f dash of x square plus I cap plus f dash of x by root of 1 plus f dash of x square j cap. So this is what t is and it is in terms of x. Now you are going to find kappa. You know that kappa should be in terms of x itself. So 1 by magnitude of v into magnitude of dt by dx, since t is now in terms of x. Let us differentiate t with respect to x. For that, see what t is. It is 1 by root of 1 plus f dash of x whole square I cap, which means that it is 1 plus f dash of x square whole raised to minus 1 by 2. You know that d by dx of x raised to minus 1 by 2 is minus 1 by 2 x raised to minus 3 by 2. So applying this, you have minus 1 by 2 1 by 1 plus f dash of x the whole square whole raised to 3 by 2. Now by using chain rule, you have to differentiate what is inside the bracket. That is into 2 f dash of x into, again you have to differentiate f dash of x to have f double dash of x I cap. Plus, now differentiating the coefficient of j cap, you have to use the quotient rule here. So first of all, you write the denominator, that is root of 1 plus f dash of x the whole square into the derivative of the numerator, that is f double dash of x minus, you then differentiate the denominator, that is 1 by 2 1 plus f dash of x the whole square raised to minus 1 by 2, since the denominator is 1 plus f dash of x square whole raised to 1 by 2, and thus we have to use this formula, that is d by dx of x raised to 1 by 2 is 1 by 2 x raised to minus 1 by 2. Into, using the chain rule, you have 2 into f dash of x, again differentiating f dash of x, you have f double dash of x into the numerator, which was f dash of x whole divided by the square of the denominator, that is 1 plus f dash of x the whole square. So this is equal to cancelling the 2's, you have f dash of x into f double dash of x by 1 plus f dash of x square whole raised to 3 by 2 I cap. Now you have to simplify the coefficient of j cap. You can see that it is a very big term and I have simplified it into this form. Let me just show you how I had simplified it. This term can be written as 1 plus f dash of x the whole square whole raised to 1 by 2 since it was the root into f double dash of x minus the 2's has been cancelled and now here there is a power of minus 1 by 2. So I can write 1 by 1 plus f dash of x square whole raised to 1 by 2. Taking it in the denominator into there are 2 f dash of x's, so f dash of x the whole square into f double dash of x whole divided by the denominator which was 1 plus f dash of x square. Simplifying this, in the numerator itself I can take the LCM. Since these both are the same terms, taking LCM I have 1 plus f dash of x square raised to 1, isn't it? Since this is a half and this is a half, into f double dash of x minus f dash of x the whole square into f double dash of x divided by 1 plus f dash of x the whole square raised to 1 by 2. That is now the numerator, whole divided by 1 plus f dash of x whole square. So you have in the denominator of the numerator the term 1 plus f dash of x square raised to 1 by 2 and 1 plus f dash of x square is the denominator of the whole term. Thus simplifying for the whole term you have the denominator, these both together as 1 plus f dash of x the whole square whole raised to 3 by 2 since there is a half here and a 1 here. This is what is written here. You can see 1 plus f dash x square f double dash minus f dash x whole square f double dash by 1 plus f dash x square whole raised to 3 by 2 j cap. This is equal to, now you have the same denominator for I cap and j cap, so you can take it common. Now the numerator is f dash of x into f double dash of x I cap plus, here you can see that 1 into f double dash of x plus f dash x whole square into f double dash of x minus f dash x whole square into f double dash of x. That is, these two terms can be cancelled so that you have f double dash of x j cap lo. So this is the simplified form of dt by dx. Thus you need the magnitude of dt by ds. The magnitude of dt by ds will be root of the coefficient of I the whole square, that is f dash of x f double dash of x the whole square plus the coefficient of j the whole square, that is f double dash of x the whole square whole divided by the denominator square, that is 1 plus f dash of x the whole square whole raised to 3 by 3, since 3 by 2 gets cancelled by the power of 2. So this is equal to, from these both you can take f double dash of x common. So f double dash of x whole square is taken common. You have 1 plus f dash of x square in the brackets divided by 1 plus f dash of x square whole raised to 3. You can cancel this to get raised to 2 in the denominator. So you have root of f double dash of x whole square by 1 plus f dash of x square the whole square. This is equal to, by cancelling the root and the square, you have magnitude of f double dash of x by 1 plus f dash of x the whole square. Thus kappa, that is the curvature, which was 1 by magnitude of v into magnitude of dt by dx will be equal to, the magnitude of v was found earlier, it was root of 1 plus f dash x the whole square. So you have 1 by root of 1 plus f dash x the whole square into magnitude of dt by dx, that is magnitude of f double dash of x by 1 plus f dash of x the whole square. here you have a power of 1 and here you have a power of half, so it both combines together to get a power of 3 by 2, and thus kappa is equal to magnitude of f double dash of x by 1 plus f dash of x square whole raised to 3 by 2. Now by using this formula, you have to find the curvature of f of x equal to natural log of cos x. So for that, first of all, you have to find f double dash of x. So the first derivative f dash of x is equal to minus sin x by cos x, since the derivative of natural log of cos x is 1 by cos x into derivative of cos x, that is minus sin x, which is equal to minus tan x. Thus f double dash of x, that is the derivative of minus tan x, will be minus sec squared x, since the derivative of tan x is sec squared x. Therefore, kappa by using this formula is equal to magnitude of f double dash of x by 1 plus f dash of x square whole raised to 3 by 2. Magnitude of f double dash of x is magnitude of minus sec square x by 1 plus f dash of x is minus tan x. So, f dash of x square will be tan square x whole raised to 3 by 2. So magnitude of minus sec square x will be sec square x by, you know, 1 plus tan square x is sec square x. So sec square x raised to 3 by 2, cancelling the 2's, you have sec cube x. Thus you can cancel this to get 1 by sec x, which is cos x. Therefore, the function natural log of cos x has the curvature cos x. This is how you do this problem.